Hey guys, what's up? It's Vittensby the StarCraft 2 Dude back with another strategy commentary for you guys. Today we're going to be looking at a series of games that I'd like to call How to Win Zerg vs. Zerg Almost Every Single Time. This is a proven strategy that I have used in about, I'd say, 21 versus 1s against other Zerg players. Right now I'm number 1 in my Platinum division. Over the past year I've been spending all my micro and macro on my kid, and she's doing great. She's been spawning these drones like crazy. Any game that I lose, guys, on the ladder, it's her playing, I swear. You know, she's getting there. She doesn't quite get the build orders down. But anyways, let's talk about the build order. So the first thing you want to do in Zerg versus Zerg when you do not know where your opponent is you want to do the extractor trick. That way you can get 11 drones. You won't take too much of a hit to your economy. And you will get the scouting information that you need to know if this strategy will work in this game. Easiest way to tell if this is going to work or not is if the Zerg player drops a hatchery. That's it. That's the easiest way to tell. If they drop a hatchery, they've already lost the game, because those 300 minerals will equal 12 Zerglings that they do not have. And of course, with your first drone, you do want to scout the far position. I chose this game because I made a small scouting mistake. You'll notice I sent my overlord to the north and then proceeded to send my drone in the same direction. You don't want to do that. One of the reasons why I've chose 5 games is because I've made mistakes and my Zerg opponents have made mistakes as well, and I wanted to share with you guys what the proper response is as opposed to what all these guys have been doing. And the proper response is Banelings. And I don't know why no one goes for it. Alright, so we did drop our 10 pool. And then now we're going to go and get the 15 or 14 extractor. The thing about the extractor is, it's important to keep in mind that this extractor should only really be used for the first 100 gas. If you want to macro back up, you should put your drones back on that gas. But if you don't want to macro up, then there's really no point in having those drones there. Just get enough for your gas and then just go all in Zerglings. There's a specific timing at around 5 minutes that you need to make a key decision if you want to expand or not. You want to get up to about 14, 12 or 14 in supply. Anywhere around there is just fine. And you want to get at least what I like to call the 4 Zergling hit squad. And the reason why the 4 Zergling hit squad is so powerful is because it takes exactly 4 Zerglings to kill a queen. You guys, that is so crucial, you have no idea. Those 4 Zerglings you see right there could go into his base and pop his queen. You'll also notice I am getting my metabolic boost. And you'll also notice that I'm just continuing to spawn Zerglings. Girl Please, that's this player's name, decides to respond with a spine crawler, which is a very smart choice. And I also dropped a spine crawler of my own, like a fool, and lost it. So the general timing that your metabolic boost, your speed, Zergling speed, is going to be done is somewhere between 5 minutes and 5 minutes and 30 seconds. It just really depends on, you know, how quickly you get gas, where your opponent is. If they're a little bit further away, you might want to get it a little earlier. The trick is with these Zerglings, you want to basically get the hatchery down to maybe about 5%. You don't want to kill the hatchery just yet. You want to keep it really low. And you want to do enough harassment so that the Zerg player that you're playing against is going to be making mistakes such as this. Every battle that you fight, you want to make sure that you have overwhelming numbers. If you're fighting a battle that they don't, that your opponent has superior numbers, you're going to lose. This player decides to respond with just all around, just very poorly. I mean, you can see like dropping a spine crawler there, and it's just a mess. Honestly, I'm not really sure what this guy could do better, except the same thing that I say to all these guys after. Why didn't you go Banelings? Like, there's plenty of time, you have lots of gas, and one Baneling can really, really mess this whole thing up. A lot of players decide to go Roaches, or other players decide to just basically go all in Zerglings. But what they don't understand is what I mentioned, which is basically that they're already 12 Zerglings down, and they literally cannot win. So thank you for joining me for one of five games in my How to Win Zerg vs. Zerg Almost Every Time series.